This is just a video I'm going to provide on an update on what I'm actually thinking at the moment. I was able to be, in a previous video, I suggested that the Groups for Health at the University of Queensland look into the relationship area, and this is something that still I find difficult because there's just no help and support available in terms of understanding the boundaries and knowing the actual cues and the requirements to be able to venture into this area. And what I'm suggesting is that as a research topic for a PhD, that compared to the Groups for Health assisting with the social isolation challenges and difficulties, of which I've been able to make one friend from that, that something be undertaken to be able to look at a broader picture. And this includes looking at relationships, because I've tried internet dating. I've tried, you know, even the very rare instances of asking women out, and I get tired of the rejection, and it just really hurts. It really is hard to deal with. It's crippling to self-esteem, and I just see it as an area that's just such a no-go zone. And I just don't think it's really acceptable because, you know, I'm 43 years old and I'm still not getting any help in this area. And I think that it's good that the Groups for Health was actually started, but through the University of Queensland Department of Psychology, but something needs to happen more in terms of the relationship area. And this is something I do ask people in the Department of Psychology to look into, because as a research topic, not only would it provide support and awareness of what the challenges are, but it would also be able to enrich the lives of people like myself that just find it incredibly difficult to be able to seek, you know, a companion or someone to share your life with. And I must admit that I still would like to have the opportunity of being in a relationship with someone of the opposite sex, but I just find that it's just so beyond me. I just don't know what to do. I don't know how to go about it. I feel powerless about it, and I just feel that, you know, sort of time's running out in a way, and it's just not a good feeling. And I just think it's something that needs to be taken on board, and I'm happy to provide assistance with it, to be able to provide what it's like to be a man with challenges. And that is that, yes, I'm going to say, yes, I'm autistic or whatever, but I just think that this just needs to be something done about this. And I just hope someone's watching and that they might come on board with some proposals to get something off the ground, because, you know, there's just nothing available. And I had an experience today and I felt quite shattered by it emotionally. And it just makes you feel like, oh, it's just no point. It's just, you know, I'm not going to be able to get the help I need or the understanding I require or the guidance that's necessary to be able to venture into the relationship minefield. So I really do encourage some input into this, and I don't think it should just be UQ, it should be any university in Australia or in the world. I also think that services are lacking for adults. You know, even if the adults that are in a relationship aren't getting the advice and support that we require. And I think it's disgusting that the government thinks that people with disabilities are a $17 billion burden. Well, I'd like to say to politicians, I think you're a burden, because you have superannuation and all these perks, and you try to push people with challenges and disabilities into unsuitable jobs when you first of all don't realise that there needs to be modifications made in employment, and secondly, there needs to be an outlawing of bullying and harassment, which can occur in workplaces, and that can severely cripple people with challenges. So that is my discussion for today. And I'm continuing to battle on as best I can, and I'm going to the chess group at the UQ, and I've also got some other friends that I'm working on, but I still have people that still don't understand me, they see that I'm difficult and they don't, and I'm greatly misunderstood as a person, and I'm still existing on the fringes of society, and I really just don't think it's good enough. I think I could be doing better and deserve better than what I have at the moment. So I just hope that things do change and that something positive does arise. So thanks very much for watching.